This could have been an ad for some bullshit like Media Cube or something, but it's not, thanks to you. Support the habit at patreon.com/doseofbuckley. It's safe to say that nearly every boy grows up going through a pro wrestling phase. And what's the first thing you think of when you think of pro wrestling? Well, sweaty half-naked men performing weird close contact moves on each other for the entertainment of straight white people who might be in denial. But what's the second thing you think of? The theme music, right? Every wrestler has a big intro with their own personalized music. And every kid grows up wishing that they just once get to walk out onto a stage or into an arena with theme music blaring in the background, getting them and the crowd pumped up. So, I guess when you're the most powerful man in the world, you can just go ahead and live out those fantasies. And no, this isn't a Trump bashing video. I'm very well aware that every modern president has made an introduction to music at some point. Hell, never mind modern presidents. James Polk walked out to Hail to the Chief because basically, according to Wikipedia, and I'm paraphrasing, he was such a nothing-looking man, he needed something to get people's attention that it was actually him walking up to his inauguration and not just any other schlub. That was in 1845. James Polk used Hail to the Chief the same way Hulk Hogan used Real American about 145 years later. So, with election season in full swing, Trump is back to doing his rallies, recently holding one at Mount Rushmore. I think it would have been way more badass if he did it with a stage on top of the mountain, looking down on his loyal subjects. Feel it would have been fitting since he believes he's above all other presidents that he's the greatest president ever, but either he actually does have limits to how egotistical he is, or they wouldn't clear it from a safety standpoint. I'd guess number two. Hey, I never said I wouldn't make a few jokes about the guy. I said this isn't a Trump bashing video. Anyway, at this Rushmore rally, he made his closing statements and left the stage to Neil Young's Rockin' in the Free World, a song he's used at least a couple times. He also walked onto the stage with it playing when he announced his intentions to run for president back in 2015. Now, Americans, I have to tell you something, and I don't know if you're gonna wanna hear it, but you guys know that every song by a Canadian that's about America is actually making fun of it, right? Another very popular song for some reason in the US is American Woman. The lyrics, American Woman, Stay Away From Me, is the Guess Who saying they don't want Canada to become like America. They don't want America seducing Canadians while bringing their war machine and ghetto scene to Canada. And Rockin' in the Free World is mocking the idea of the US being free at all, talking about the homeless problem, drug abuse, pollution. There's one line that suggests a woman throws a child in a garbage can to go get high, and the song even specifically references George Bush's Thousand Points of Light. It's a protest song about Republicans. The lyric, Keep on Rockin' in the Free World, is cynical, sarcastic. It would be like playing Neil Young's Southern Man at a rally in Alabama. But Neil Young doesn't care about any of that. He just doesn't want Trump playing his music because he doesn't like Trump. Tom Petty, The Rolling Stones, Rihanna, and Guns N' Roses, among others, have also voiced their displeasure with their songs being played at Trump events. Musicians are generally more left-leaning. Most entertainers seem to be, which has always been interesting to me because they stand to save more money on taxes generally and keep more for themselves under a conservative government. But either way, this is why you never heard anyone getting mad at Obama for using music. It wasn't like he was walking out to Cat Scratch Fever by Ted Nugent. But if it did happen, old Teddy would have just as much luck doing something about it as Neil Young or anyone else I mentioned. They're all shit out of luck. Why? Because musicians have little to no control over their own music because of the insane systems that have been set up. Now, it's hard to feel sorry for millionaires, especially when I tell you what they're opting into. But this is my fucking wheelhouse. Get ready for Professor Buckley to teach you all about music licensing. Why can Trump use whatever songs he wants while all these musicians just have to hashtag deal with it? The answer is PRO, Performance Rights Organizations. Every single time a song plays in public, anywhere, the music industry wants their cut. They'd fucking charge you a quarter for singing in the fucking shower if they could. I guarantee it, the fucking music industry. In fact, this is a true story. They fucking tried to make the Girl Scouts of America pay money to sing songs around a goddamn campfire. These greasy fucking pricks. So, you ever been to a bar, restaurant, mall, arcade, bowling alley, a wedding, a goddamn dentist's office, and heard music playing? It doesn't matter what the source is. It doesn't matter if it's from the local radio station, if the owner of the place bought a bunch of music from Apple Music and puts it on shuffle, if they got a DJ spinning vinyl, or even if a cover band is performing. In order for them to do so legally, they must pay licensing fees to PROs. And not just one, because what if one of those organizations isn't working with a specific artist or label, right? So in the US, there's like 5 fucking PROs, and the 2 biggest ones are BMI and ASCAP. Which sounds like a bowel disease and a product to stop it. Do you have BMI? If you can't stop yourself from shitting, try the all-new ASCAP. It'll plug you up in seconds. A venue pays them a monthly fee, and then they're pretty much covered for whatever songs they want to play. But, Buckley, how does the artist get that money? Do these venues have to write down every single song they play? How does IBS and Asshat or whatever know who gets how much? The answer to that last question? They fucking don't. Artists and labels sign up with a PRO, they also have to pay money for that, then the PRO distributes money based on some secret sauce that they don't tell anyone about, but theoretically is based on popularity, or the size of the label, or how large your catalog is, or maybe based on the few sources that do report everything they play, like radio stations, which obviously don't play much in the way of indie or niche genres. So, if you're some nobody independent artist and you sign up with a PRO, and then somehow you convince a bar down the street to play only your music, that bar's monthly fee doesn't 100% go to you. In fact, you'd see a very minuscule percentage, maybe fractions of a penny, because you're nobody. Now, what about that whole thing where someone on Trump's staff used Linkin Park in a campaign video and posted it on Twitter? If you didn't see it before it was taken down, Dan Scavino, Trump's deputy chief of staff for communications and social media director, and formerly the manager of one of his golf clubs, posted a video of a bunch of clips of Trump set to Linkin Park's In the End. Well, that's a different license than this one. Paying BMI and ASCAP doesn't give you the rights to use clips on social media. You have to go through the copyright owner and get permission. Through their other licenses, Trump could walk out to Linkin Park at a rally and they couldn't do shit. But once they posted a video with the music in it, someone from Linkin Park can issue a DMCA claim and get the video taken off Twitter, which they did. Now, why someone from any campaign would use a song like In the End when the message of the song is it doesn't matter what the outcome is, failure's inevitable, and we all just die, and why someone on the Trump team would use a Linkin Park song when the late Chester Bennington once called Trump a greater threat to the United States than terrorism, I'll never know. But I guess that's what happens when your social media director is the guy who used to make sure the pro shop didn't run out of Titleists and that all the golf carts were fully charged. So back to Neil Young, who wrote a protest song about America and then fucking moved there and got full citizenship. Yeah, you're writing protest songs about the US, but you don't mind living on your ranch in California, almost definitely paying fewer taxes than you would living in Canada. And I bet the second you're sick, you'll hop a plane back here for some of that free healthcare. Or, you're so rich now anyway, you'll just say fuck it and use your money to jump the line for treatment in the States. So, you can imagine I'm not too heartbroken to tell you. When Neil Young's Rockin' in the Free World gets played at a Trump rally, Neil doesn't even get paid any extra. The Trump organization is paying ASCAP or BMI or both of them a monthly fee to be allowed to use whatever music they want at events. And Neil Young gets the same royalty check every month no matter what. So why do artists do this? Because the alternative is to either have to independently collect money from every single individual place that might use your music, which would cost more in admin fees than it would be worth, that's why they use a middleman, or not allow their music to be played anywhere, which I'm actually surprised old Neil hasn't done anyway. Remember, he's the fucking idiot that wouldn't put his music on any streaming services because they weren't good enough to play such high quality dog shit as Hey Hey My My. Out of the blue. And into the black. Yeah, you gotta hear that in fucking wave format. So he released Pono, the uncomfortable looking triangle that would play lossless audio from an exclusive service. It failed in 2 years because, guess what? The average person either can't tell the difference or doesn't give a shit about high quality audio. They listen through shit earbuds or crappy speakers on their phone. But if you don't work with a PRO, you don't get the royalties when your songs play in public. So, if Neil really wanted to make a statement, he could pull his music from all PROs and then say, "I'm doing this because of Trump. Until he stops playing my music, no one can hear it." Presumably, he owns the rights to do so, since he had the rights to put it on his own doomed platform to begin with, and decided to pull it and put it back on other streaming services. So, what I'm saying is all Neil Young would have to do is cut off his coke-filled nose to spite his face in order to get Trump to stop playing the song. Same with all these other artists bitching about their music being used by a politician they don't like. But I guess they just can't part with the few cents they make every time Dave and Buster's is playing their songs over top of a bunch of screaming children getting their snot-caked hands all over every fucking skee-ball in the place.